In this video, we'll see how to evaluate the z-test statistic and p-value for the two-proportion z-test. The instructions for the TI-83 and 84 are identical. And we'll start with this example, the same one we used for the two-proportion z-interval. Just to summarize the problem, we have a current supplier and we have a prospective supplier. And we want to know, is there evidence that the prospective supplier has a higher rate of passing the inspection? Because if they do, we're going to go with them. So our null hypothesis is that the true proportions that would pass inspection are the same for the two groups. And our alternate hypothesis, the one we're trying to see if there's evidence for, is that the prospective supplier has a higher rate of passing inspection than the current supplier. So first we carry out the initial steps. We set our significance level alpha. We have to assume that there's two independent random samples here. And now, different from when we did the two proportion z interval, we're going to look at this quantity, which is the pooled proportion p hat. And the reason for this is because we have a null claim that says that the p1 equals p2. So similarly to when we did the one proportion z test, and we had a hypothesized value for p, we use that hypothesized value in checking our conditions and in calculating the SE. So here, what we're going to do is use our best estimate for what this proportion that these two equal might be. And so our best estimate for that is to combine our two sample proportions. And we do that by adding the total number of yeses over the total sample size. And here we get 0.9285. So this quantity we're going to use when we check our conditions, and we're also going to use it in the SE formula. So here we have our N1 p hat, N1 1 minus p hat, N2 p hat, and N2 1 minus p hat are all greater than or equal to 10. And now when we calculate our SE, we have to go to the formula sheet, and we're looking at the difference of sample proportions. And we have the special case where P1 equals P2. This is our null hypothesis. So because we have this hypothesis here, we're going to use this structure written here for our SE. So we have P hat here, 1 minus P hat, etc. So we fill in the numbers. And now we're ready to grab the calculator. So we always start with stat tests. And this time we're going to go to 2-prop z-test. So let's go to stat tests and find 2-prop z-test. 2-prop z-test, here it is. So x1 is 899. n1 is the sample size of 1,000. x2 is 958. Remember, x1 and x2 have to be integers. Of course, n1 and n2 have to be integers as well. So n2 is also 1,000. And now our alternate claim is that p1 is less than p2. So we'll choose the less than. And now we'll do calculate. And we see we get a z-score of minus 5.12. And a p-value very, very small. Notice this also gives you p hat, the pooled proportion. So here's our 0.9285, which is what we calculated here, and they match. So what's our conclusion? Our p value is much less than alpha, so we reject H0. We have evidence that the prospective supplier has a higher true pass inspection than the current supplier. So we should go with the prospective supplier. That's it for this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Thanks for watching.